Hello gamers and other motherfuckers. Welcome back to another Unishit review. Today we will talk about the small plane with big Russian bias attached, the Polycarp of I-153 nicknamed Chaker. This motherfucker is a BR-2-point Rusky biplane capable of delivering communism to your doorstep, and will make your enemies shit their pants. This bias machine won't let you down. I can tell you that. The I in the name, stand for I love this thing. But this thing is what happens when you give Russian scientists and shit the right to modify a normal I-50. That is also why it has retractable gear. They just let them do whatever the fuck they want. But now to the history shit about this plane. This thing was designed because the CR-32s of the Spaghetti Air Force were better than the I-16s. Well, if this is why it was made, and it was made by Zekomis as well, does it have stellium? Simply said, no. The scientists of the Russians thought it was a good idea to make the frame out of steel, but not really anything else. They just made 25.5 layers of cardboard and thought that would do it, and added to that, there is no stellium in the wings as well. It will rip at 580 kilometers an hour, at least it is better than the OP-2. So it will not protect you. How about the guns then? This piece of Rusky has 4 communism launchers that have one hell of a fire rate. If you aim correctly at someone for 1 to 2 seconds, you will spray about 2 to 3 pounds of a mix between communism and stellium in their faces. The downside is that it are small 7.7mm launchers, so it won't be too powerful because the bullets are too cute. You will only make them laugh if you don't know what aiming is. But combining the fire rate with the right belt, you will set some bitches on fire. So the 7.7s are strong if used correctly. Now for the ammo. How much does it have? It has 2400 and something rounds. This is a lot. But because this has the fire rate of a minigun, you shouldn't spray and pray, but use it. Only if you know you will hit, otherwise you will overheat the guns and run out of ammo. Now for the secondary armament. What kind of ground pound power does it have? Well, it has 4.50 pound or kilo, I don't exactly know, bombs where you have to be really accurate with to kill, because they are so small, or you use the 8 missiles in different variations. The first one is the RS-82. This is a high explosive missile, probably for plane based attacks, because there is almost no penetration. The second one is the RBS-82, which penetrates armor and explodes when inside the tank. This one is an anti-tank rocket, and also the main one to use. Now let's talk about special things about this plane. It has retractable gear, something almost no biplane has in the game. This improves the aerodynamics, so it will be a bit faster because of this. It also has the best engine of all the biplanes. It has really good climb rate for the type of plane that it is, and is decently fast as well. This glorious plane is so fucking maneuverable. Sometimes I think that I have turned around in like 1 to 2 seconds, because it is so goddamn fast. It will outturn every fucktard in the entire game. Mike Snail made the bias even greater by making sure that this bias machine is at BR 2.0. Mike Snail, what the fuck is going on in your brain? This plane should be at 10.0, because it is so goddamn good in the right hands. This is also why there are fuckers that just go in at BR 8 or 9. And then still get kills for days. Gaijin, just what the fuck. But because all of this, you will face German propaganda firing 20mm guns that will tear your shit up. Now for the cons. It has none. Wait, it does. Somehow.
No!
It has low speed above 3500 meters. The engine overheats pretty fast. It is vulnerable to heavy damage, because most of the stellium went to other projects. The engine is made out of wood, so one hit and you have to retreat back to base with your fat ass. A single machine gun round to the engine is capable of knocking it out, like I just said. Defensive armaments of bombers can easily wreck this aircraft's engine. The glorious machine gun's prone to overheat because they fire so goddamn fast. It is vulnerable to boom and zoom, especially when climbing. It is not suited to head-on attacks because there is almost no stellium in this plane. The modifications and crew skills. I would recommend to get some new belts first for more firecrackers, then do the entire mobility line, because maneuverability and engine bias. Only then you should go for the bombs and rockets, because ground pounding. Then do whatever is left. With the crew skills, you should focus on stamina and vitality first, and then for repair, because goddammit, my engine got hit. Well, this was it. Hope you guys enjoyed. and for now bye, because these things cost time. This will be something totally different, but care. I would have loved to make it RHAKER, but because I'm a PS4 bastard I can't. See you guys next time. Enjoy the footage.